today here on The Now. A popular baby product has been linked to dozens of deaths. We're getting answers on safety surrounding padded crib bumpers and why the product is still in stores. It can be easy to overspend around the holidays. Stores aren't making it any easier. We're letting you in on the secret tricks so you don't fall for them. And airport security is changing to offer even better protection against threats. We're checking out the new technology that includes giving bomb-sniffing dogs some extra help.
Thanks, Annie. I'm Amanda Starantino, and thanks for joining us on The Now Indy. With Thanksgiving and a big meal just 2 days away, have you ever wondered why you love some things that are being served and the person next to you can't stand it? RTV6's Kelsey Anderson tells us about a study happening at Purdue University that's trying to explain why we all taste food differently.
Some people think this is too bitter and this is too sweet. And a lab here at Purdue University is trying to figure out why we experience food the way we do.
So my research is all about saliva, perception, ingestion, and tongues, which is why we call it the Spit Lab.
Corey Running is an assistant professor at Purdue University. The students in her Spit Lab are working to find out why we experience food the way we do.
And so we study things like how you experience that food, what you think about that food, how you eat that food, and also how it is biochemically broken down in your mouth. That's the spit part.
Each student in her lab gets to conduct their own experiment. Sophomore Madeline Harper is working to combine two sciences in her experiment.
Biology and psychology to figure out the patterns of why people like to eat what they eat.
Harper is making different solutions and having the participants answer questions about the taste verbally and electronically to see if their answers differ.
It's helped me realize how much science goes into basic things like eating and perceiving the flavors of the things that we eat. Yeah. And I just think that's really interesting.
Running says, based on the results they've gotten so far, the way we taste food is pretty complex.
What you eat can actually change your saliva. And those changes in your saliva could then in turn influence the flavor of what you're eating, which means it's a circle. It comes back. So what you ate changed the flavor of what you ate, and that's gonna change your spit in ways that changes the flavor of what you ate, and that might change what you decide to eat. And so it gets to be a complex relationship.
If you want to learn more and be a part of this research, head over to theindychannel.com. Working for you, Kelsey Anderson, RTV6.
Interesting stuff. You can also find it at theindychannel.com, how you can participate in this study. They're looking for more people to get involved. Indiana Republican Senators Mike Braun and Todd Young this week introduced legislation to rename the post office in Dana after celebrating Indiana war correspondent Ernie Pyle. Pyle was born near Dana in Vermilion County. Pyle was reporting on the U.S. Army's 305th Infantry Regiment when he was killed on April 18, 1945. Congressman Larry Bouchon has introduced similar legislation in the House. Kevin.
Let's head down to Bloomington. There's the steel gray overcast. You can see campus lights coming into view and a few birds there swirling around. We've had the winds gusts between 20 and 30 there. I think we'll see wind gusts through the evening hours continue across central Indiana to increase. The wind right now southeast at about 15 miles per hour. Let's talk about the changes that are ahead this evening. If you're headed out, take your umbrella. Expanding area of rain southwest of Indianapolis. We'll zoom in closer just to the northwest of Bloomington, also to your southwest. Here's a little more intense rainfall. All this drifting from Rockville to Greencastle, eventually to Martinsville, and there's more behind it. We're setting up a wet 12 hours here probably until about 5 o'clock in the morning tomorrow. Temperatures, they're mild and won't change much between now and tomorrow morning. The strong south wind will keep our temperatures above average and keep these from falling off too much. Rain likely 40 mile per hour gusts late. Then as we go through the overnight hours, 7 to 9 this evening, rain, and then by 11, widespread rain expected.
Let's start the Now News feed. D.C. is the latest to join a lawsuit against Juul. The nation's capital and a number of states say the company's advertising targeted minors. There are more states considering a possible lawsuit. And the University of North Carolina is making changes amid claims of anti-Semitism. Reports indicate a conference at the school featured a rapper who was accused of using anti-Jewish rhetoric. The school will be holding expanded anti-bias training as part of the changes. A new bill being discussed in the House could improve your rights on the internet. The online privacy legislation would make changes like giving you the ability to ask for data to be deleted. It would also make companies get permission for getting sensitive information. And life life expectancy for people in the U.S. is getting shorter. That's according to a study published in JAMA. People are now expected to live for about 78 years. Researchers say drug overdoses, suicides, alcohol-related illnesses, and obesity are to blame. Well, the White House is stepping up its fight against the opioid crisis. Today, the president pledged to donate his third quarter salary to the Office of the Assistant Secretary of Health. That's $100,000 that was been earmarked for public health offices and programs. And today, the First Lady was in Baltimore to speak to young people about the epidemic. She encouraged them to talk to a trusted adult if they're struggling with addiction.
I'm in this fight with you, and I'm fighting for you. I encourage you, if you are struggling with addiction right now, reach out for support.
People who specialize in helping people conquer addiction say that's the first step, but more needs to be done to get rid of the stigma, because that's usually what stops people from seeking for help.
We know there's a big disconnect between people believing that it is a disease and like other medical problems. People go to hospitals to get well. They can go to treatment to get well.
The stigma can often affect how people pay for treatment. Many insurance companies don't consider addiction a disease and will often deny coverage for it. Experts add that decriminalizing drugs can also help change how addiction is seen. All right, still ahead on the Now, a popular baby product has been linked to dozens of deaths. And we're getting answers on safety surrounding padded crib bumpers and why the product is still in stores.
Prices at Ross. Yes for less.
A group of young adults took a big step to change their future path. There are 38 new grads of the Yes Indy Power Huddle program. We first showed you this program in hiring Hoosiers back in June. It is 2 weeks of intensive training sessions for people to learn employability skills and help them take the next steps towards a career path. This takes place at the Boys and Girls Club of Indianapolis and at Eastern Star Church on the Far East Side. According to Employ Indy, there are more than 30,000 opportunity youth, that's young adults between the ages of 16 and 24, who have disengaged and disconnected from secondary education and/or the workforce. This program is to re-engage those youth to connect them back into our workforce.
Checking in on the Now News feed, cardiovascular problems are a bigger concern for cancer patients than the rest of the population. A new study says 10% of cancer patients actually die from issues like stroke or heart disease. Doctors say this stresses the need for patients to receive care from multiple departments. Researchers at Michigan State say focus isn't the only issue caused by sleep deprivation. The team found that memory can also be affected. They say this debunks the theory that focus is the only victim of not getting enough rest. Well, there is still a stigma in the U.S. surrounding AIDS. That's according to a new study. It found the stigma is especially prevalent for younger Americans. Now, 28% of millennials have avoided interacting with someone simply because they had AIDS. Crib bumpers are a popular accessory for baby or nursery rooms, and they're usually used by parents who are trying to avoid their baby getting injured by the slats of the crib. But children's safety advocates say the risks of using crib bumpers are far more serious. Bumpers have the potential to block babies from breathing. Babies can even get tangled up or strangled by these products. Pediatric experts say going without the bumper is much safer.
Even in the worst case scenario, if an arm or leg gets caught, the worst case is that a baby's going to wake up. And while that's not ideal for a family necessarily, it's not going to lead to an injury for the baby.
Walmart and Target have stopped selling crib bumpers. Some states like New York and Ohio have already banned them, but federal bills on this have gotten some pushback. The Washington Post reports the Consumer Product Safety Commission doesn't believe crib bumpers have played a role in these infant deaths. So the commission is planning on inviting experts to weigh in on the product next year. And checking back on our lineup, stores have all kinds of secret tricks to get you to buy more this holiday season. Ahead on the Now, we're exposing their tactics so you don't end up overspending.
PM Wednesday only at Ashley Home Store.
The FDA is issuing a new advisory to people who use CBD. The agency is stressing there are still a lot of unknowns about the product. It also says people should talk to their doctors before starting the use of CBD. Right now, the FDA has only approved one CBD product. It's used to treat epilepsy.
One church is making sure the names of gun violence victims aren't forgotten. It wants people to take notice about an issue advocates are fighting to stop. Chris Stewart has the story from New Orleans.
Gun violence in New Orleans, like many places,
the city is still killing over 100 people a year,
is often defined by numbers.
Numbers dehumanize, names humanize.
On the walls outside St. Anna's, it's defined by people and a problem.
I would say 95%, if we look at the murder board, of homicides are done by guns.
Father Bill Terry is a native of New Orleans. Since 2007, he's written the name of every murder victim in the city on what he calls the murder board.
You know, I don't pay attention to numbers. It doesn't matter. If it looks like a lot, it's a lot.
Last year, New Orleans had its least amount of murders in 47 years. But still, last year, Father Terry put up 146 names.
My dad was murdered before Hurricane Katrina, July of 2000.
Tamara Jackson Snowden knows the pain of violence in New Orleans. She's the director of Silences Violence. The group advocates for victims of crime and their families.
There's minimal to no resources for those individuals who are impacted by gun violence.
Gun violence is responsible for nearly 90% of the murders in New Orleans, but Tamara says the issue is about more than just guns.
We need to change the storyline. We need to change the dynamic. Poverty is an issue, education is an issue, and until we address those things, we can continue to be in the situations in which we are.
And while Father Terry says it's not about the numbers, the fact his church ran out of room on the walls outside with more than 2,000 names speaks volumes.
As Americans, as human beings, to see young people murdered is a very emotional thing.
And that's why this priest is praying the conversation changes.
Where it's a zero-sum game. You're either for guns or you're against guns. And neither route is going to be terribly successful in this country, and neither route is going to successfully address the issue of urban gun violence.
But until then, he will continue to put each name on display outside his church to make sure the stories of New Orleans murder victims aren't lost in the numbers, rates, and statistics.
Chris, thank you. Advocates are worried about children's ability to get a flu shot. A number of states have laws in place that don't allow kids to get a flu shot at the pharmacy. Instead, parents are required to take them to a pediatrician.
And as far as total flu vaccination coverage in the U.S., some states are better than others at making sure kids are vaccinated. Numbers from the CDC show in the 2017-2018 season, Indiana ranked 12th worst in the nation in getting kids vaccinated for the flu, with only 51.7% vaccinated. Rhode Island had the most vaccinated at 76%. And we've been looking at the lights for a while now, but tomorrow the lights at the Brickyard officially open to the public at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. A Pagoda Cam provides a great view of a portion of the 2-mile course that gives you a chance to actually drive on the track. Gates open tomorrow at 6. Standard admission is $25 Monday through Wednesday and $30 a car Thursday through Sunday. The event runs through January 5th.
From those lights to the lights of Monument Circle, looking pretty good downtown. Now the steadier rain is just to the southwest, and so that is going to change the complexion of the evening. Rain and even some thunderstorms. I think the thunderstorms are more likely after midnight, but we may hear a rumble before that. 60-mile-per-hour wind gusts headline the forecast for tomorrow. That's why a high wind warning is in effect. A dry and calmer Thanksgiving. That will be easy to accomplish after those winds tomorrow. Looking at the radar, Indianapolis, we've had some sprinkles or light showers at times. You go down Interstate 70, once you get toward Cloverdale, Greencastle, that's the leading edge of the rain. That will roll into Hendricks County. Then between Martinsville and Nashville through Bloomington, we've had some rain, and there's more to the southwest. That's why I think we get in a situation here where we have the steadier rainfall through about 5 a.m. It's all snow on the backside. Some of that is significant. The only flight delays have been out of Denver, and they've averaged around an hour here recently. 53 in Indy, the wind out of the southeast. This will start to gust between 20 and 30 as we go through the evening. Then after midnight, they'll pick up even more. Notice what doesn't change. Temperatures will stay in the 50s. 7 o'clock, rain, especially southern half of the state. More widespread rain as we get to 11 o'clock tonight. That zips east. An additional spotty thunderstorm through the overnight, and then by 7 a.m. we turn our attention not to the radar but to falling temperatures and also rising winds. Temperatures during the day tomorrow going backwards, lower 50s at 8 a.m. We'll be dropping into the 30s by the time we get to the evening hours, but 42 and very windy tomorrow at 4 p.m.
Tis the season to shop till you drop, but before you pull out your wallet, we want to show you how to save money. And it's not through couponing or searching for deals online. It starts with what you do when you walk through the doors of a store. Whether you're aware of it or not, a store is laid out in a very specific way to get you to spend more. Those huge shopping carts are always conveniently placed right as you walk in, but those small baskets, they seem harder to find. Well, the stores hope that you'll fill up that shopping cart with more items than if you had a small basket. Gone are the days of stores playing elevator music to create a sense of calmness. Now it's all about upbeat music to create a happy atmosphere, hoping you want to stay and also shop a little bit longer. Just like speed bumps on the road, stores have them too, in order to get you to slow down and look at more items. So they place tables, clothing racks, and obstacles all throughout the store. How about those big signs that say buy one, get the next one half off? Well, they seem like they're a great deal, and they are if you're planning on already buying two. But if you only needed one, buying another half off is still getting you to spend more than you were planning on. And when you're ready to try on clothes, don't be tricked by the sale rack that's usually placed right by the dressing rooms in the back. It's one last chance for stores to get you to pick up more items. And here's one final last tip. You're gonna see a lot of discount signs with 10, 20, maybe even 50% off an item. But consumer experts say nothing is a deal unless it's 30% off or more. Checking in on the Now News feed, a stern warning from the UN when it comes to climate change. The group stresses the world isn't doing enough to address the issue. It says with the track that we're on right now, there could be dangerous consequences by the year 2100. And meanwhile, a secretive startup company backed by Bill Gates could help the environment. It says it created a process to help generate the extreme heat needed for industrial processes like steel and glass making. The big takeaway, it would help replace the need for fossil fuels in those industries. Well, do you have an annual football game with family and friends on Thanksgiving? Maybe a so-called turkey bowl? The bookmaker William Hill US has created a way to bet on the game by creating a spread. It takes into account even the college athletes in the family, as well as things like everyone's height, health, and fitness. Well, a new report raising concerns about the conditions in Amazon's warehouses. The Atlantic, along with another group, found the e-commerce giant mostly skirted safety regulators until 2015. The report says part of that included trying to hide injury logs. On top of that, the investigation found the injury logs may not have been accurate as Amazon tried to manipulate injury reporting. Amazon has not commented on that report. And a new report says the ads you see on Amazon's online marketplace are affecting your shopping experience. Experts say customers have reported frustration with the number of ads they see. Amazon is currently the third largest ad platform behind Google and Facebook. However, Amazon is cashing in with billions of dollars in ad sales. Experts add that the advertisements don't appear to be affecting sales. And Facebook just launched a new app targeted on doing market research. The app called Viewpoints allows people to do things like taking surveys. In exchange, you get rewards. So one of the initial surveys available is about your health. And if you fill it out, you could get $5. Finally, in our lineup, airport security is changing to offer even better protection against threats. And it could make it easier for us in the security line, too. We're checking out the new technology that includes giving bomb-sniffing dogs some extra help.